every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Well, good morning, grace and peace from God our Father. Welcome to Fresh Start. First Start is our morning devotional, where we go into the Word of God, focus our thoughts for the morning, and build our faith based upon the Word of God. Fresh Start as a title really comes from Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse number 23, where the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is His faithfulness to you and I. And I want to thank each and every one of you who log on every single morning to this morning devotional. And I really want to thank those of you who share this morning devotional with others and invite them to be a part of our short time in the Word of God, but still a powerful time in the Word of God. Let me begin with the final lesson in this series of thoughts regarding help for unbelief. It's found in Mark chapter number 9. Let's go there again, verse number 24. The Bible says, "And straightway the father of the child cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe, help thou my unbelief." I begin thinking about this particular passage of scripture, and I begin to think, if God gives help for unbelief, how did Jesus answer this man when he said, help my unbelief? What was the help that God gave through Jesus, through the ministry of Jesus? What was the help that this man received from Jesus? If you read the account in Mark chapter number 9, you'll discover that the next thing that happens is that Jesus heals his son. Now, let's rewind. The man has a problem, his son needs help, the disciples couldn't help. Jesus says, I'm ready to help. Do you believe it? The man says, I believe, but help my unbelief. There's some things I do believe, but there are other things I don't believe, and I need you to help me. I begin to think, what was the help that Jesus gave him? He performed a miracle. Now, I want to encourage those of you who are still waiting on your miracle. Let me give you our fresh focus for today to end this particular lesson. Yesterday, we talked about how we need to, begin with what we do believe. But let me share this with you. Jesus helped his unbelief by working a miracle. While you wait on God to do this, notice that He has already done that. Okay, Bishop, what are you trying to say? The man received help by the Lord working a miracle. Well, if I'm now dealing with unbelief in my own life, even as a believer, and I thought about the things that God has already done, and I thought about things that I do believe, rather, about God, in an effort to deal with my unbelief, and while I wait on God to do what He can do, let me praise Him for what He's already done. Now, I'm waiting on Him to do this, but I thank Him that He's already done that. I want to say that again. While I am believing God afresh, I'm not going to waste any time repeating myself and begging and asking God for the same thing over and over again, because Jesus taught against that when He taught us how to pray. He says, don't use vain repetition. Lord, do it. 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 Lord, that's vain repetition. That's a whole nother lesson. But if I'm dealing with unbelief, let me understand that unbelief can be remedied by me spending time thanking God, that while I'm waiting on God to do what He hasn't done yet, I'm praising Him for what He's already done. I'm thanking him for what he's already done. And when I do that, it builds my faith for what I believe he's going to do in my life. When I begin to rehearse what God has already done, he's already healed before, he's already delivered before, he's already provided before, and I know and I believe that God can do it again. He can do it. Do me a favor. I don't ask you to do it too much, but do me a favor. Put it in the chat. God can do it again. Put it in the chat area. God can do it again. He can do it again. He can do it again. I don't care how difficult it may sound. I don't know what you're up against, but God can do it again. While I'm waiting on God to do that, I'm going to praise him because he's already done this. Or I can say it this way. While I'm waiting on God to do this, that I'm waiting on him, I'm going to praise him because he's already done that. He's already done so many wonderful things in my life. God has done so much for me. My old pastor would say, he's opened doors I could not see. I'll keep on trusting, for his word is true. He's already done what he said he would do. I called and he heard, and he gave me peace of mind. He's my shelter. He's my shepherd. He's my guide. And he's with me all the time. I don't worry. I don't fret. God never failed me yet. I'm going to keep on trusting, for his word is true, because he's already done what he said he will do. I'll see you in the morning. God bless. The gospel. This is the good news. Tell everybody how he said.